It's a fact, these very parliament buildings burned down in 1906, all except for the library. But that's because we make our books out of rocks. That has nothing to do with comic books, but this does. Cuius custodiet ipso custodes. If you don't know what that means, you need to listen to this.
I'm here today with Alan Moore here at the Tower Bridge in London. How are you doing today, Alan?
I'm doing very well, thank you.
Glad you could make the trip down from Northampton.
Yeah, I don't make it very often. A little special reason, so I'll try and drag myself out of bed, you know.
One question that comes to mind. You and Dave Gibbons have any idea the impact that the Watchmen was going to have?
About 3 issues in, yes. Not to start with. Originally, we planned to do just a very clever, exciting superhero book with a few neat twists. Round about the 3rd issue, something strange started to happen in the mix. You know, we started to notice that there were interesting layers of storytelling going on between what was happening in the captions, what was happening in the pictures, the dialogue, the little strip about the pirates that was embedded in the overall strip. There was a peculiar point of interaction that I'd never actually seen in comics before. When we realised we were doing it, we decided that that was what the comic was about.
With all the hoopla and excitement and enthusiasm that went down with that, like when you look back, is it something you're still proud of? Do you think it still hold up for you, the Watchmen?
Watchmen still holds up for me. I still think Watchmen was a great work. It's not without its flaws, no work is. The hoopla that surrounded it has rather blunted some of its appeal. To me, I'm often reminded of something that David Bowie said when he described himself as the face that had lost 1,000 pretensions. You know, and there's some truth about that regarding Watchmen. Watchmen did seem to open the doors for a lot of people who had... They've grasped the surface of Watchmen. They've grasped that it had got grittier violence, a more adult approach to sexuality. They probably couldn't grasp exactly how to do some of the clever semiotic stuff that we were doing, but they got the sex and violence, the pretension, the references to popular song lyrics, things like that, which all made it very 80s and very modern. And I've seen a lot of retreads of that kind of comic sensibility since that to me have seemed depressing, pretentious, and yet I have to own up to a certain paternity there. You know, the child is ugly, but it's probably mine. You know, and that has tended to blunt it a bit. I wouldn't like to say that Watchmen had a good effect upon comics. I think it was a good comic book, but I wouldn't like to say that it hasn't had necessarily a good effect upon comics. It might just have doomed us to 10 years of heavy-handed protection.
Looking back on the Watchmen, Alan, is there anything you wish you'd done differently?
No. I think that I'm pretty happy with it as it was. I could have done differently. Yeah, it was perhaps not all of it was the book that people wanted to read, but all of it was the book that I wanted to write. What I was trying to do in Watchmen was to use a lot of comic book icons in the plot, in the characters, but to do something different with them. And as such, I think it was perfectly successful at what it did. You know, it's, I'm happy with it. I'll stand by Watchmen.